Went to bed around 9, like I said. And I sweated all night. It rained all night too. Had crazy dreams. I felt sick the whole time, even as I was sleeping. Took a Benadryl. I took a Buckley's pill as well. So I'm feeling a little bit better right now, which is good. I was worried. It's not a hot day today. There's overcast. Looks like it might even rain. So I'm gonna get a break from the heat. But my bites are something else. The one on my leg won't stop oozing. I've treated it like 5 times. So I don't know, man, if it has anything to do with it or not. I really don't know, but my foot is so swollen that I can't fit it in my shoe properly. I'm really, really hoping and praying that this is gonna stop and then I can feel normal on this trip, or somewhat normal. Well, we're out on the boats, I'm feeling a lot better. There's only one problem, my leg is infected. I got bit up a bunch of times like you saw there, and then I was wearing my neoprene sock all day yesterday, and we were walking through muck and gunk and all that stuff, and it got in there and rubbed and rubbed and rubbed and rubbed and rubbed all on the bites there, so it's infected. So we got to watch it. Don't have any antibiotics or anything like that, so hopefully it'll be okay. I think everything's gonna be fine. It's a nice cloudy day today. We've switched up the road a little bit. Preparation and planning for this trip, we kind of misjudged how rough the portages were and how long it was going to take to get through them. In the first 3 or 4 days we portaged, we barely were in the boats. We were paddling for 5 minutes portage, paddle for 5 minutes portage, and it really beat us up. It's taken longer. We've averaged 17 to 20 kilometers on other trips through Algonquin and Killarney and stuff, but here we're doing like, what do you say, 10? Tops 10 clicks a day. So originally we wanted to go see Maple Mountain, we wanted to see the old growth pine, and we wanted to go on Lady Evelyn River. Well, we did the river. We're not going to be able to do the old growth pine or the Maple Mountain because it's just taking too much time. It's taking a lot longer than what we expected, and we don't want to get to the car on Sunday at 6 o'clock at night and have to drive 12-14 hours home, however long it takes us. Yeah, so it's okay. We're allowed to make switches to the plan out here. We knew that going in. And yeah, it's all part of it. So next time we will know. And we gotta judge what kind of trip we want to do too. Like, we're trying to get in fishing time. We're spending hours a day fishing and trying to make up time at the end. It's just not working. So I think it's gotta be either a fishing trip or a hard ass trip where we're trying to put in kilometers and stuff. So it's all a learning curve still. It's a new park. It's a wild park, man. This place is wild. It's a lot more remote and wilderness-like than anything we've ever been at. Well, this is the most we've paddled in one stretch for the whole trip. I'm paddling for 2 hours or so.
I know. It's pretty bad.
And how many kilometers do you think we put under?
We did 3.7 plus 1.5. Whatever that is.
Right, 3.7 plus 1.5 kilometers in 2 hours. And this was the pace that we were expecting to go at. But anyways, let's take a look at the map.
So we camped out right here. It's a nice campsite. Paddled down this way. Really nice weather so far. We are I think we're at that campsite right now. Got 3.9 up to here and then a couple of short portages. It says they're not well marked and muddy, so we'll see what happens. And then we'll be in the Willow Isle Lake. And I'm thinking we can head up this way, maybe hit one of the, you know, these campsites somewhere in here, depending on how we feel and how bad these portages go. And then, yeah, doing pretty good.
Pretty nice.
Perfect, man. The sun, the breeze.
Sun's coming out. beautiful right now. Look at that backdrop. Just gorgeous. Well, lots of stuff has happened since the last time I checked in. We did these port, so the sun came out, obviously. I think it was cloudy last time I was talking to you, and into the wind. What time did we start today? 8:30? So 8:30 till 5, solid day paddling, mostly paddling, but we did have to do two portages, three portages. Two were marked poor condition on the map. And one was 600 and one was 300. The 600 meter one, we got lost like 10 times. There was no kind of trail, no kind of anything. There was a little blaze where somebody came and blazed a little bit, like scraped the bark off a tree. But that was few and far between. And then we had to walk out into a bog for like, I don't know, a couple hundred meters or whatever.
That was fun.
I like standing waist deep in bog.
But we found this site, beautiful lake. Beautiful sight, nice and open. I'm eating my chili now, so just getting everything ready. Try and take it easy tonight and do some fishing, hang out by the fire, and have some drinks. It's today's been a much better day. And I'm very thankful for that. Well, this is night 5. This is a great sight. You can see behind me, I have my all my stuff drying out. It's already dry, I'm just leaving it to air out now. The last night when it rained, everything got soaked. I had to pack it in the backpack this morning. And what I did was, instead of putting it the tent in its stuff sack, I just laid it in the flat in the bottom of the dry bag, my big backpack, put a garbage bag over top of it, and then pile all my gear in on top of it like that. That way it's kind of protecting everything else from getting wet from the fly in the tent. My sleeping bag was soaking wet with sweat from last night. Like I said, I don't know what the heck, man, but I sweat like crazy last night. Like I was trying to like rid my body of something. I don't know. But anyways, it's up drying now. I got my pants in front of me here, my neoprene socks, my liners. Everything's drying. Everything's gonna be nice for tonight. I got a sweet view in front of my tent here. The other side of the lake is probably 100 yards right in front of me. In a little channel, it opens up nice there, big rocks and everything. So great view, sun setting right in front of me. Things are looking up.
So that was fun to wake up to at 2 a.m. I have a little pack towel. I was able to soak it up, most of it, and drain it outside. So when we got to camp tonight, I was able to roll back the vestibule, face it right into the sun.
So the site is nice, very scenic, but it's very slopey and very rocky as well. So we're having to peg out with some rocks, which is no big deal. Stack a couple if you can't find a big one. I might go and try to find a bigger one for that because it's my vestibule and because I will be opening and shutting it. On this trip, I wanted a different saw, one that wasn't made of wood. So I ended up getting the Agawa Canyon Boreal 21. It makes short work of wood. It's a really good cutter. It packs up and down really quick. And that's one of the things I like about it. I don't want to have to spend any more time doing anything that I don't want to or have to do out here. So. We're gonna go fishing. Before then, I have to put everything that I want away and where it needs to go. So this is all the stuff I want in my sleeping or in my tent, and I have to move quick because the black flies will get in there really quickly. Last night I probably had a good 20 in with me, and that's no good. So gotta move quick. In my ear. Ready? Yeah. So many bugs.
Fishing time.
It's a gorgeous night. I'm gonna fish right off that rock. Oh, snagged on the rock.
It's wild here, man. Can't catch a fish to save my life, but it's wild here. I don't get it. I'm trolling, I'm jigging, I'm using spoons, I'm using meps, aglias, rapalas. Pike usually are not an issue to catch. I'm really glad I caught that trout. Otherwise... but it's a nice night, man. The sun is still hot. It's like 8 o'clock at night. More out. This is a rough trip. It's been a tough trip for me already. It's a it's an awesome trip, rugged place, but it has been rough. So how many fish did you catch?
Oh, it's huge. This big, threw them back.
There's no fish here.
I don't get it. I mean it. We've tried everything.
There's no way it's us.
No, I can't. This isn't the right area. This is not a pikey area right here. What?
Yeah, it is.
No, it's not.
Walleye too, I think.
Okay, you're out in the lakes. This is like a little tiny channel.
We're running.
What's wrong, Kyle?
Got my fruit punch here.
Is it horrible or what?
Pretty boozy. I need to throw another packet in.
Oh, from a guy who loves his fruit punch.
I the key is don't have the one that has caffeine in it, these little packs, because otherwise then you can't sleep very well.
Because Kyle's little self can't handle the caffeines. He hasn't grown up yet. Oh, says the guy who can't grow a beard.
Yeah, exactly. The guy that gets carted every single time by milk.
They tell me it's a good thing. To buy milk?
Yeah. You old enough for that there, sonny?
Did you say milk?
Yeah.
Milk.
Milk.
Like with an E?
How do you say the word about? Why don't you work on that?
About.
You don't. That's not how you say it in your videos.
About.
No, you don't. You're
about.
You're like, about. Everyone that I have watched your videos is like, about.
Okay, y'all.
I don't say that. That's a...
What do you say?
Measure.
That's measure and yeah, weigh and measure.
Weigh and measure.
And then there was another one too. It was like measure. It had the same kind of letter scheme.
That's so specific.
Wow. So here's my update on my bites. I have now cankles. I'm a very skinny boy, as you can tell. And my ankle usually protrudes much more than that. Now I have cankles and an infection. Yeah. And that's just this leg. Now we have this leg. Oh, look at that. Wonderful. Wonderful.
What are you doing crying like a girl over here?
What are you doing crying like a girl?
You got your little bug there. You can get big veins. Rub some lotion on it. Put some rub on it. I told you that's how to sterilize it. Listen to me.
Did you pack the Vagisil?
That's what you need, not me. Not the one sitting here.
Okay, what about when we're in the portage and you're swearing up a storm, you're like screaming as loud, like the people in like Ohio can hear you because you're screaming the F word so darn loud.
Well, I almost broke my leg. Here, you want to compare battle wounds? Look at that. That's a war wound right there.
Do you have an infection that you might die from though? Because I do.
No.
I'm camping.
I have a strong body.
Look at the difference in our legs. Look at this.
They're, yeah.
Like a boy and a fat
guy.
Don't think of yourself as such a fat person, Joe. It's okay.
Oh. So you're the boy.
Damn it.
Just sterilizing my pot. I'm boiling up some water.
Sterilize it with booze.
Oh my gosh, rub some dirt on it.
Yeah, dirt and alcohol will fix it.
We've been hanging our bear bags every night, obviously. I've been hanging my pot with it, with my spork and my stove and all that fun stuff. Toothpaste, bug repellent, sunscreen, stuff like that. So we haven't had a problem. We haven't seen a bear. I would like to. I haven't seen a moose. We've seen sign of moose. I've seen a ton of wolf poo. Big, big, round wolf poo, too. Like, no mistaking. But I haven't seen anything. It doesn't help that this guy is, like, the loudest, most obnoxious canoe partner in the world.
And you're just a peach to deal with. No problems at all.
I'm severely injured. Oh.
Sounds like a you problem, not a me
problem. What was your favorite part of this trip so far?
The booze? No.
You said that last time. We got that on... Anyways.
It's true, though. I mean, usually. Because okay. That's the one time I can drone out you.
Right, you can deal with me.
Yeah.
So, honestly, though. What's a highlight? Maybe not favorite,
okay,
but what's
okay.
a highlight?
A few highlights. A, catching the brook trout. That was awesome.
Yeah, and mine then, was way bigger, but yeah.
Just because I had to show you how to catch them once I taught you up.
Mm-mm, taught me up good.
Anyways, we'll see what happened tomorrow night. And then that one campsite with the waterfalls was pretty cool.
That was pretty spectacular.
There were 3 billion black flies, but whatever.
What sticks out in my head is running the rapids, even though it was not much.
Yes,
but
that was fun.
The first that I've done of that.
I enjoyed that right up until the point where I saw the crack in my boat. That
yeah, well, if you missed the rocks like old Joe here, you'd be all right, bud.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then I also enjoyed catching an enormous brook trout, which was quickly diminished by my lack of normal person memory and knock my... Beep.
Bam! Look at that, Joe. First time on trip. You haven't spilled it.
So we haven't seen anyone past the second day, which was really the first morning. We were paddling. It was one motorboat that went by, the same guys we talked to at the put-in. And then there was, two guys in a cedar canoe? Yeah.
Two canoers, yep.
And they were...
That was at like 9:30 on Sunday, right?
No, yeah, right
Saturday,
off.
Saturday.
Right off the hop.
Saturday. Yeah, and it's Wednesday now. We haven't seen anyone. We haven't seen very much, like, very little, like, trash or anything like that.
I haven't seen another canoe. We've seen a couple boats docked, just stashed there for like maybe fly-ins, but we haven't seen a single person. Deafening quiet, except for the constant buzzing of the bugs.
Yep.
And at night, the spring peepers are going crazy, and the birds.
And we saw our first float plane today too.
Yes, we saw a float plane flying.
Yep.
I think the difficulty level from this park to what we're used to is a little bit more extreme. We've done Killarney and Algonquin a bunch of times, and this is more rugged and less populated, less traveled than either of those places. Today on one of the portages, like I was saying earlier, we literally were lost. Like, we had to dump our canoe, dump our packs, everything, go back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, trying to find it. We actually found a Nalgene, a lime green Nalgene, with puncture holes in it that look like teeth, for sure. So I imagine that's from a bear. Do you remember, what was the portage called?
I don't know. I'll put it in my map video, but I think it was a 525. All these portages seem like they're either really, really rugged on the rivers, or they've been not maintained at all. Like, no one's been down through that portage we went with a saw in, I don't know, 5 years probably.
So we were on the river. Whoa! Gonna drop the camera. We were on the river for what? The first
three or four days.
We're off the river for like a day and a half, 2 days, and then we'll be back on the river going up at parts, but different branches too, getting home. So, lots of river trip, lots of crazy portages, not lots of fish.
Oh, that Gray's Creek that we have to go up right before the 3000, it could be another Birchcliff Creek kind of thing. It says the word shallows in the middle. There's a little arrow.
Oh my gosh. What you're telling me.
It's so stupid.
What?
You and your bug thing is so stupid. You look like a Teletubby with a Drain's axe murderer look kind of.
And your full bug jacket is better?
Oh, that's styling, man.
It's not made for beekeeping.
It's not made for beekeeping. Which is good because you almost put your tent on top of a bee's nest one day.
When was that?
You even got second day. Remember that? There's those hornets and those giant flying ants. There's not a lot of insects out
there. There was a lot of insects there.
There's giant flying ants. There's like these like 3-inch long tarantulas.
Tarantula!
Tarantulas. And then there's...
Mystical.
1 trillion bajillion times a million black flies out there.
There's probably more than that, I think.
You think so?
You know what? I think I killed more than that in my tent last night.
Oh, I've eaten... I've counted. It was 7 yesterday and at least 6 today.
That you've eaten.
Yeah.
I've got a couple.
The problem is, it's not like, oh, they get in my mouth. It's like, they fly in and it's like a choking thing. And it's usually right as I have the canoe on my head and I'm single carrying and we're up a hill and you can't find the trail. And it's.
Remember when I was trying to describe to you the black fly situation and you were like, no, it's not that bad.
They're nothing. These are nothing compared to mosquitoes. I swear those mosquitoes.
I think there's two different thoughts on that because I've talked to people as well, other people, and they said the same thing. But I'm going to go with black flies are the devil over everything.
Okay.
Like, it's a good thing black flies don't carry Lyme disease because we would be all limey.
The nice thing about the black flies are if it's cold, they don't go around.
Right.
If it's windy, they're not here. And if it's dark, they're not around.
That's very true.
With the mosquitoes in Lake Superior, 100%, 24 hours a day, 365 in the tent. After you.
Yeah, I got him in the tent too. Do you remember the portage where we were walking in the marsh? Remember that black fly situation?
Which one? That was like every portage today.
The bad one today.
Oh, the last one. Okay.
Remember the black fly situation there?
Yeah, I was cursing a lot. The number one issue with that was there was the cloud of black flies that I was eating at the same time as being stuck up to my waist in muck. That was the problem. That's why I didn't like the black flies.
Was that the problem?
You're the problem too.
Meh. All right, folks. Day 5 in the books. Day 5 in the books. Rough day, not too bad. Time for bed, it's about 10:30. Both had a healthy portion of spirits. Should sleep pretty good tonight. So not too bad a day tomorrow, but Friday is going to be rough. What's the name of the game in this park? Rough.
Good morning. Woke up to a beautiful day. It's about 7 o'clock on Wilson Lake. Just packing down camp now. Got to get up and move on again. That's the name of the game. So, good night's sleep. Good campsite. Do we have a rough day today, or is it whatever?
Just a lot of portages. A
lot of portages. That's what I like to hear in the morning. This tent is full of debris. From me walking around with my socks on, getting stuff stuck to my socks, cutting up to pee at night, and all that stuff. But because it's a freestanding tent, I'm able to take everything out of it, unhook it from its pegs, or unpeg it, or whatever, and just kind of shake her out. Just shake it off. You know, just shake it off. Get all the dead black flies and mosquitoes out. My sleeping pad is actually stained black from the guts of black flies. So, bonus.
Well, we're back on the water.
It's around the point up there, and then you can head back down.
Now, judging by these clouds, looks like we might get into some weather. But can't really complain. We haven't had any real rain except for the first day when we came in and a couple nights ago as we were sleeping. So 9 days, gotta be expected.
In old Frank's Falls, we got a portage around. She's a rager, bud.
So this is the first time we saw some people since day two. We got some nice guys fishing up at the falls there. The guy pulled a walleye out right in front of us. A super jelly, grape jelly. And oh look, gray jay. See him? See how he's flying? That's pretty cool. Yeah, so it's raining now. One guy said it was supposed to rain on and off for the next 2 days. The other guy said it was supposed to be 25 degrees Celsius, which is hot today. And that's not happening. It's raining, but I'm rejuvenated again. Ate some food, drank some water. Found out that there was actually fish here.
No.
So he's using minnows, the guy who just pulled the walleye out. And then the other two guys, there was one guy at the bottom, two guys at the top. The guy at the bottom in the boat was using minnows. The two guys at the top weren't catching anything and they were using spinners. So the guy who caught the walleye was using a minnow. Makes me think I should use my minnow-shaped lures on my jig, or my minnow-shaped bait on my jig. Maybe that's what I will do.
One day it started raining. There's all kinds of rain. Rain comes up from the bottom.
Here comes the rain. She's coming down now. We're in back into the Lady Evelyn River. Pitter patter, let's get at her. I'm not hating this rain one bit, I'll tell you that much. No bugs. Nice and cool. This is what I expected from a May Northern Ontario canoeing trip. So now we're headed to a portage named the Golden Staircase. I can only assume that that means it's very vertical and gaining elevation. Right? Golden Staircase sounds like that. So it'll be nice to do that in the rain with the wet rocks and mud. Nice and slippy. We'll see just how bad it is, because some of the portages we've already done have been pretty brutal. Well, it looks like we have the same idea, Mr. Kyle. Head mount GoPro time?
Yeah, let's do it, man.
Yeah, I dumped my canoe out first.
Oh, it's a cute
one. Fancy pants. Alrighty. Bouncing off trees. Golden Staircase. Whoa! Them rocks is slippery. Here's the staircase. Rough portage. Great view though. I got about halfway and dumped the canoe. Kyle did the same. So we're just trying to find the trail right now. There's a little campsite here that kind of obstructs it. Doing okay?
No. I'm not real stable. I'm so fucking heavy. With that pack, I have no stability. My fucking ankles are jacked up. I'm done with this river shit, man. These damn rocks are like oil covered. It sucks.
Do you want a swig of booze?
No!
One swig of booze will help you.
I guarantee it.
Snap my leg off back here.
Well, it's not going to make a difference except for you won't be pissed off about it. Just have a swig of booze, Kyle. It's noon.
Is it noon already? What makes it? This is a 100-meter portage. It took us an hour to get through.
No, it didn't. No, it didn't.
265. And then like 100 meters. I think maybe we can dry out. I feel like a wet sock right now. Are you done filming? I'm glad you're having fun. You were the one that was crying earlier.
Oh yeah, I'm not denying that. For like 3-4 days I was crying.
Dehydrated again.
Yep, drink some booze. That'll help. Good day.
Stopped raining now for maybe the first time in like 4 or 5 hours. And yeah, it's still staying cool, not buggy. So we're gonna get to our campsite really soon. We got, like I said, one more portage and like a 20 minute paddle or something. So it'll be good. Probably put up the tarp tonight just in case it keeps raining.
We're at our sixth campsite. We just pulled in. I'm freezing. I'm chilled to the bone. So I got it. First thing is get out my tent, change, lay in my sleeping bag for a little bit. I came to this awesome flat area.
Look, there's a flat spot here too.
It's fantastic. We can be neighbors.
Can I open my door this way staring longingly into your eyes?
Yes, and I will not return. Oh, man. Yeah, I'm chilled, bud. So yeah, I set up the tent, climb in the sleeping bag for like 5-10 minutes, warm right up. Food, water.
Can we get the cup of soup?
Cup of soup.
Got the old tent all set up, and I'm sitting in here, just kind of warming up, relaxing. It keeps threatening to rain again. I know last clip it looked a little sunny, and it did. It was sunny for a minute, but yeah, it's threatening to rain again. So Kyle hung up a tarp. He's getting his stuff squared away, and I'm going to relax in here for a bit. I wanted to give you guys an update on my danky legs. They're now purple, which I don't know if it's just because I'm cold or what, but the swelling has gone down on my ankle. Not such a cankle anymore. It's a little bit, but you can see when I touch it, the white stays. For a sec, I got one up big enough here, a bad one here, my foot. Oh, that's the mark from the duct tape. I had duct tape and gauze on it the other day. Oh look, a black fly is caught in my pants. Die, you piece of crap. Look at that. Look at that. Would you look at it? Look at it. Just look at it. Oh god. Oh, I got him on my forehead, dude. I got like 5-6 bites on my forehead. I didn't even know. Oh my gosh. Just heating up some water to rehydrate my rice and gravel dinner. This Bush Buddy's been working awesome for this trip. One of the big winners for sure.
Here we are, here's Catherine. And it took us a half a day to go from here to here last time. So we could go probably in a full day somewhere up in one of these sites. And then we could head out if we wanted. Or we could do from here to here, from there to there, and then out. Because my original idea was to go from here, follow this river that could be unnavigable, 3,000 meter portage, 7 kilometers of paddling, 3 portages equaling about 1,000 meters, and then another 4 kilometers of paddling. Then we have to walk down the road 3 clicks.
So what do you propose we do?
I would rather take the one that we know is going to work than the one that we think may work. Does that sound good? This deep into the trip?
Why did you wink at me when you said that?
I didn't know.
You're like, does that
It's really
good?
Weird with you and the camera this close. And it's,
like, you've never made a video before.
I know.
Burly outdoors. Burly outdoors.
Oh, my God. I have. It's just like you. Yes, exactly. Now
wow. Aren't I a sight? So, we're out fishing. Hoping to catch some trout. I know I sound like a broken record when I'm saying this, but it is reality out here. It is legit. This is a hard place to be. It's a beautiful place to be. I really enjoy it. There's been a lot of cool things that have happened. But we're done. We've both agreed on it. So I think we're going to do 8 days instead of 9. We'll do 7 nights and we'll leave Saturday midday. That'll be the 8th day. So I'm cutting it short a day. No big deal. My wife will be happy. Where are the fish?
I don't know, where are they? I thought your job at one point in time was to catch fish like professionally.
What?
You have your ponar, you can't do it? What?
Ponar's for picking up sediment.
Whatever.
You're confusing it with sonar.
Yeah, I think you need your ponar in order to find fish.
You need your ponar check, boy.
Yeah.
Alright, you want to go back to camp and drink and eat?
Yeah, drink and eat, yes.
Because we're not doing much of it.
Like, honestly, there's no fish.
You don't care.
Any fish. Like, even if I caught, like, some little piece of junk right now, I'd throw it back, I'd be like, it'd be awesome. Like, pretty much the only thing you caught last trip, if I caught that,
right.
I'd be happy.
So I think, award for A, biggest fish, and B, nicest fish, go to Uncle Joe over here. You have more. Yeah, you have. Yeah, because, you know, what you can't have in quantity, quality, damn it. Quality you make up in quantity. Son of a gun, I messed it up. All right.
Here, rip.
Yep. As per Joe. I was racking my head to see which one went first, and I pulled the wrong trigger. We're gonna touch butts here. Oh, nice. When we've been going fishing at night, we've been hanging our bear bag up off the ground so that no animals come or whatnot, not necessarily bears. Now we're gonna get down and eat some food. What do you think about this bush buddy, Kyle?
I'm a fan, man. It's pretty cool. I like how it fits in your pot. It's one connected piece. It burns quick. Even when everything was wet today, you got it fired up in, you know, under 5 minutes. So I don't know what's a better way to go. That, the pocket rocket, the alcohol stove.
I think they're all just maybe preferences and different situations.
I agree.
What are you doing with your hands?
I'm on the drums.
Oh, okay, I'm on the bass then.
I'm not on the Air Force, man!
You know, two of them are dead now?
We talking about this earlier today.
One lonely beastie IB. Get it? Because two of them are dead. There was three of them.
This is my Hawaii song.
It's actually pretty sad, to be honest. I grew up with the Beastie Boys.
This is some hot chick singing.
Oh my God! You have the ecstasy. Are you in a rave right now? Where's the glow sticks, homie? Alright, folks, day and night 6 in the books. Not too bad of a day, all things considered. Pretty tipsy, not gonna lie. We decided to drink a bunch of our booze so we can save on weight tomorrow. And hopefully that won't be a late start tomorrow morning. A little detrimental to our start, but good night. It started raining as we went to bed, so that's all right with me. It can rain all night. Hell, it can rain tomorrow for all I care. It's better than the sun and the bugs in my mind. All right, guys, good night. I'll see you in the morning. Peace. Morning, day 7. Feeling a little dehydrated. I think I drank a little bit too much last night, so I'm gonna chug the water and Advil it this morning and get on with her. I think tonight will be our last night now.
seven nights, 8 days, instead of 8 nights, 9 days. It's not even 6 in the morning. I can't, every time I drink too much, I wake up really early in the morning. I can't go back to sleep. It doesn't make sense, but it's what it is. So. Stupid decision. It was all Kyle egging me on. Oh, just drink some more. I carried all this freaking booze for you. Meanwhile, when we're at the liquor store, oh, you better buy more booze, Joe, because I'm not sharing with you. He bought a 60. He bought a 60 of booze, Sailor Jerry. And he bought vodka. bought airplane vodka and whiskey as well. He's a friggin' lush.
Bring me my food, Sherpa.
Kula,
Sherpa.
Should I set my flags up?
Oh, I ruined your joke. I'm sorry.
Damn it, I had planned that for months.
So it's a sexy shorts kind of day today.
Oh yeah, man. Freaking hot out already.
It is pretty hot.
It's gonna be bad out there on the water.
I'm not looking forward to that at all.
It's better rain.
No.
For me at least.
How you feeling?
Beat. Like I feel like I slept a solid 8 hours, but I feel like I didn't sleep like 2 minutes.
Do you think it's possible maybe we drank a little bit too much?
That is a possibility, yeah. Sailor, I think, got after us a little bit. We were having fun, though.
Yeah.
Fun last night. This morning, not so much.
Right.
Friggin' bugs are back out.
I wonder if, we'll ever learn.
No, we won't. No, this will happen. It's a repetitive theme in all of our videos.
Alright, time to put on my daily burn digits. I already wiped it with an alcohol swab. Got that one done. I gotta put one on my finger too because she's super infected. But yeah, it's not so swollen this morning. I have been taking Advil, one in the morning, one at night. So
just walking along the longest portage we have left. This is 700. Kyle and I both planned on single carrying it, but things change. So he dropped his canoe. Maybe halfway, so did I, and I didn't even, the funny thing is I didn't even see him drop it, and he's like maybe 20 feet in front of me, got the canoe on my head, he drops his, and I'm like, oh man, I can't go any longer, I gotta drop my canoe, just walk with my pack. I always feels a little crappy when that happens, but then I put my canoe down and look to see Kyle had put his maybe 20 feet in front of me, maybe makes me feel a little bit better about myself, about my manhood. So we're doubling back now, grab the canoes, the pack's already there. Doubling back, grab the canoes. And like I said, that was the longest portage left of the trip. We have 10 more portages before we're at the car over the course of today and tomorrow. But they're all like 340, 70, 90s. Oh, look who I see. Look, who's that guy?
What's going on, buddy?
Oh, I just, you know, took my second poop.
Your camera again. I'm working.
Took my second poop of the day.
Second
at 9:30. I'm a big boy. Oh, it's real talk out here, boys and girls. Real talk. These rocks are so slick from all the dew and rain. I do have to say these shoes are doing pretty good. There's the beauty. There she is. A little worse for wear after this trip, but nothing a little TLC can't take care of. So, shore lunch. Just taking a break on the end of the portage. My meat and pita have seen better days, but that's fine with me. I'm gonna eat it up good.
Now that we're going backwards up the river, we have to get in at rapids like that. So it's taken a lot of hard paddling to get up to the portage area because you're fighting the current.
That and it rained a ton.
Yeah, yesterday. So
way up.
We're paddling now.
Still paddling into the wind against the current, but
This is a real beauty part of the lake. It's wild looking. That sun is hot, guys. Full sun, roaster, 12 o'clock. Pretty rocky portage. We've already done this one on the way in, so we kind of knew what to expect. On these really rocky up and down ones, we're not even attempting single carries. It's just not worth it. Plus they're shorter, so it's no big deal. We gotta paddle up all that to get to that portage right there. We've been seeing lots of signs of forest fire. There's an old remnant stump. Harsh land.
Land of the big ants.
That was the wrong way. My eye is gonna swell shut, I think. A bit on the eyelid. I am reacting to these bites like crazy, like nothing else, man. Kyle's not at all, and I'm getting all sorts of messed up from them. Got one on the back of my kneecap. It's like, it looks horrible. I can't even bend my knee. Look at that thing.
You gotta kill all the fish, man, that stench.
So I took a look at the map and we got a pretty decent sight here. We know there's fish right around in here.
That's where Kyle caught his brookie.
Yep. So we're going to stay here tonight, and then tomorrow we got a 345, a 280, and a 4 kilometer paddle off the car. So that should take like, we should get there by noon, I'm thinking.
So this is a very good site. It'd be a really nice site, a nice place to spend our last night. There's a lake up there we can take the canoes up to if we wanted to, yep. Or fish this. We're gonna stay here. It's 1:38. We've been busting our butts since 8 o'clock. We're gonna stop here because this is a spectacular site. I'm gonna go swim again. Oh, this water feels so good on my bug bites. It's super slippery.
Okay, that might be enough for me. It's pretty cold.
We've been traveling roughly 8 hours a day, every day, starting at around 7 or 8 in the morning and ending at like 4 or 5 at night, with the exception of today. Today's day 7. We started at around 8 and we stopped at around 1:30 or 2. And we're gonna spend our last night, our night 7 here. Because it's beautiful, as you've seen, this is a sweet sight. What I'm looking at right in front of me is like a picture, man, or a painting. It's beautiful. So we're gonna hang out here, relax, have some fun, and then tomorrow we'll get up and paddle till about noon, and that'll be day 8. We'll be at the car around noon. We only have a couple more portages to do, nothing too substantial. So that's pretty good. I'm looking forward to that. Looking forward to going home. To be honest with you, I've had a good time. I've had a hard time.
This will be a lot of tight B fun. Editing this video, watching this video later on will be a lot of fun. There's been some times here that I wasn't having fun. There's a couple times I didn't have fun. I wasn't having fun here. And it's, what would you say?
You said a couple.
That's true.
More
than a couple, he says. I actually said to Kyle, for the first time ever in any trip, I hate this. I wish I never came. And that was when I was deathly sick on the Portage Trail, like, what, 4 days ago now or something like that? It was rough, guys. Real rough. So I've never said that. And Kyle has said some things this trip, too, that he that I've never heard before. So it's all learning. But anyways, we're going to cut it a day short, like I told you probably 1,000 times, because I can't remember what I've filmed, what I haven't, with 3 cameras. the reason being, we're done. Also, my legs reacting real bad, so we've had enough. We've seen what we wanted to see. We've been paddling upriver now for quite some time. It's a lot of work, but this is a great sight, like I was saying. This is all making it worthwhile. This isn't where Kyle caught his trout. I was mistaken. This is where Kyle cooked up his trout. I fished here while Kyle was cooking his trout and obviously didn't catch anything here. I have to have someone to talk to.
Right.
Anyways.
American makes crappy conversation, doesn't it?
Well, you shouldn't say that about a full race or nation. Like, just because of your inadequacies doesn't mean the whole country is at fault, Kyla. This guy over here.
Right up close. I'm literally sitting in a rapid in this boat. No hands. I'm not paddling or anything. I'm just like sitting in this little rapid. It's awesome. I love this boat.
I see Kyle hanging the bear bag up. That must mean he's coming up to fish too. Play in the rapids or take pictures. He's getting in his boat, I think.
This is all fat wood. Super high fat pitch content. This would be good stuff. Ba-bam! Yep. That's cool stuff.
Been loving this bush, buddy. All I've been doing is literally lighting twigs on fire, tossing them in. I'm cooking every supper with it. I'm gonna rehydrate spaghetti tonight. So what I'm gonna do, what I have been doing, which has been working the best way for me, is been getting water from the river, putting it on, letting it boil,
then pouring my food into the pot. And then I'll leave it for like, I don't know, a half an hour, not even. And then everything, that way, not is it just hot, and some things rehydrated, everything is juicy, everything's plump, except for the gravel, of course. But you can see how quickly this goes up. I'm loving it, man. Got it on a rock here because this is kind of like a dry looking place. The topography and geography of this specific place we're at is completely different than a lot of the other places we've been on this trip. And we were just talking about that. Back there, it looks almost like it's Montana out west.
I just ate a black fly. I saw it land on the spoon as I was putting it in my mouth.
We were just talking about how the year's almost half up. Isn't that crazy? Wasn't it just winter? Wasn't it just Christmas, New Year's? Time flies. You gotta go get out and do stuff when you can. This will be my 20th night out this year. I feel lucky to have that many. I have an understanding wife. So, feel blessed about that. I'm gonna keep it up. I'm trying to make 50. We'll do 50 nights this year.
We're gonna go portage past the falls into the next lake and fish. It's 6:30 now and we're gonna stay up for a while.
That was awesome. I hope I got that. I saw him fly by. I started cawing at him. He replied. It was cool.
The beaver who lives in this lodge came out and smacked his tail at me twice. You can see it starts here in the water, goes up. It's just a small one.
It's gotta be us. There's fish here. We just can't catch them. I need somebody to teach me. I did all my research beforehand coming here. And I'm not fishing correctly for sure, so I need to get lessons.
Kyle made us a nice white man's fire. Keep the bugs away.
Tomorrow is we've got two portages, a 365 and a 240, and then about 5 clicks of paddle. We should be back to the car. Now hopefully, hopefully the car starts, it hasn't been vandalized, it's still there. All these things have been running through my head, but see when we get there.
What about the steak we left in the car?
You left a steak in the car?
Not much going on tonight. We stayed up by the fire until 11 o'clock. Only drank a couple drinks each. I think we still felt overdone from last night. But last campsite, night 7. 7 nights in Temagami. Tomorrow will be day 8. And it'll take about half the day to get to the car. So it's not so bad. We are actually going to get a hotel in Barrie, or a motel in Barrie, and stay there, get a stuffed crust pizza, get some IPA beers, sleep there. That'll be about a 5 or 6 hour drive from here, and then in the next morning we'll make a 5 or 6 hour drive home, and then Kyle's got another 3 hour drive home from there. Catch up with you tomorrow. Good night. See you in the morning.
Good morning. Day 8. 6 in the morning. Starting to rain. We got about a half day's travel to the car, so I'm gonna get up, get at him, and I'll get back with you.
I haven't had the chance to scare Kyle or prank him at all on this trip. Let's go see if we can scare him awake.
Pitter patter, let's get at her!
Good, that was payback for your freaking Voyager's bullcrap in Algonquin. Oh, I was dead asleep. Well, now you're not, bud. Get up. 6 o'clock. Because we gotta go and it's starting to rain. Nope.
Great success.
They call me Mellow Yellow, quite rightly. It's before your time, I think, son.
Yeah, you're really old.
Boom, 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 boom. You know?
It could just be your crappy singing, that's why I don't know
anything. I'm just a wild about saffron. Saffron's wild about me. I'm just a me- No?
I'm glad you're in a good
mood. They call me me- What?
Woke me up very early this morning.
Oh, that was payback, bud.
Yeah, it wasn't nice. It
was you're right. You're right, it wasn't.
I was dead asleep.
Mm-hmm. Is this our last portage?
This is our last portage, buddy.
High five! It's raining. I actually don't mind paddling in the rain. It's kind of nice.
Why did they make this river so long?
Should write a letter.
Yeah, should write a letter.
Is it raining?
I think so.
Oh my gosh, we went the wrong way for like 500 meters here. Friggin' Ferdinand Magellan over here. All you can do is laugh. Got a misty mountain up ahead. It's pretty cool looking. We're almost at the car. Land ho. That was our Temagami journey. This place is rough. But gorgeous. We'll definitely be back. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time.
Did you really have to do the little thing there at the end?